Showboat, the Hammerstein and Kern musical that premiered 75 years ago, featured one of the most hauntingly beautiful songs of the 20th century. But first, the songwriters teased audiences with this cheerful minstrel of slaves working on the docks. Now, in fact, if you invert the melody of Cotton Blossom, it becomes something else altogether. Joining us to talk about the history of Old Man River in all of its various incarnations is Murray Horowitz, former Vice President of Cultural Programming here at NPR. You know, I'd wondered what happened to you. And who's now Director of the American Film Institute Silver Theater and Cultural Center. Murray, welcome back.
Hey, Scott, it's great to be back.
The first person to record Old Man River is a very famous name in the history of American song, but not the first name you would pick to record this.
Not at all. Not at all. And he was a very young man and part of a singing group who sort of stepped out on his own with the Paul Whiteman Orchestra, their Bingle, Bing Crosby.
Old Man River, that old man river, he don't say nothing, but he must know something because he just keeps rolling. He keeps rolling along, rolling along. He don't plant tears, he don't plant time. And that plant on his soon forgotten that old man river, he keeps rolling along. You and me, we sweat and strain, body all aching and racked with pain.
It was a different world in 1928, but nowadays we would just about find this tasteless, wouldn't we?
I guess.
And he was a great singer, don't get me
wrong. He was a great singer, and I guess I should stipulate that I'm not positive he was the first person to record it, but he was the one who made it a hit. This was a big hit for the Paul Whiteman Orchestra, and they played dance music. So this is the kind of tempo, dump, 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 that you could do the turkey trot to, or even the Charleston, and it's this very sort of jolly, moving along thing. But that insistent rhythm that just makes the song eternal. Dum dum da-da, dum dum da-da, that just keeps building and building to the end of the song, is there, and so it's good at any tempo.
Now, I gather that the great Paul Robeson was delayed in his recording of the song because, well, he was supposed to premiere the show in Washington, D.C., but...
The show was written with him in mind for the part of Joe, who introduces the song Old Man River. Robeson, though, was simply unavailable by the time the show got staged in New York in late 1927, and so he was able to recreate the role in London and was a big success in the part there.
Over the years, what has made the song so powerful as a song?
It's a lot about race and death. It's not a vapid I love you song. I get weary and sick of trying. I'm tired of living but scared of dying. I mean, that's something that strikes a chord with a lot of folks.
Yeah.
And that insistent pulse, that four syllable. I mean, what river are we talking about in Showboat?
We're talking about Mississippi.
Mississippi. Bum, 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 Mississippi.
Yeah.
And that pulse goes on throughout the whole song.
It's like the pulse of the river
itself.
Yeah.
And so it's a great composition. And finally, it really is like the best American music tapped into the African American tradition. It depends not only on minstrelsy, but on blues and on spirituals for sure, and that I think accounts for a lot of its staying power.
This weekend, June of 1928, Paul Robeson goes into a studio and records what has become one of the best-known songs in history.
Yeah, and very closely identified with Robeson. It's not that he went in the studio then. This was the week that the song hit the charts. And from then on, it was one of Robeson's signature pieces, maybe his most important signature piece.
Let me contribute something from my own much smaller area of knowledge. In 1948, the great Jackie Robinson testified before a congressional committee and criticized Paul Robeson, whom he admired, for not recognizing the crimes of Stalinism. Right. In 1949, Paul Robeson performed at the Grand Hall of the Moscow Conservatory. Now, we're told this recording was locked up for years in the forbidden section of Soviet radio archives until just a few years ago. The background is, of course, he knew people who were getting arrested in Stalin's anti-Zionist campaigns and Stalin's campaigns against artists and intellectuals. Here's that recording.
There's an old man called the Mississippi. That's the old man I don't like to be. What does he care if the world's got trouble? What does he care if the land ain't free?
That's the voice that the United States kicked out of.
Listening to it now, more than 50 years after the fact, do you think Paul Robeson knew more than he let on?
Oh, yeah, no, we do, because he had a friend, the Yiddish poet, Itzhak Pfeffer, and he insisted on meeting with Pfeffer, even though the authorities discouraged it, and Pfeffer drew an index finger across his throat to say they were being executed, and Pfeffer himself was among those shot to death in 1950. When Robeson understood that, he went, maybe that night, the next night, I'm not sure of the detail, to give that recital that we just heard. And toward the end of the concert, maybe as an encore, he sang the song of the Zona Partisans in Yiddish, Zognit Kainmol and Bugatsin Lestinveg, Never Say You're Traveling Down the Final Mile. And it was greeted with thunderous applause, because everybody knew what was going on. And the fact that he acknowledged that he knew what was going on was important, and I have no doubt that that performance of Old Man River was similarly informed.
Lift that barge, lift that veil, you show a little grit, and you land in a tear. But I keep laughing instead of crying. I must keep fighting until I'm a dying. And Old Man River, he'll just keep rolling
would think other artists, even great artists, would be reluctant to perform and record this song after Paul Robeson had his way with it over the years and it became his song. But
I brought along a recording from, I think it's 1960, Tony Bennett in his famous Carnegie Hall concert featuring the great conga drummer Candido.
River, that old man river, he must know something, but he don't say nothing. He just keeps rolling, keeps on rolling along. He don't plant taters and he don't plant cotton.
It should have changed taters to mangoes. I don't know.
Anybody else's recorded version over the years, in your mind, become a signature?
Well, maybe America's greatest singer, Ray Charles. I mean, Ray Charles does this in a way that I think speaks to us, and it's a wonderful piece.
I know that a old man river. That old man river.
Great talking to you again, Murray.
Always a pleasure.
You're welcome anytime.
Thank you.
Murray Horowitz, director of the American Film Institute, Silver Theater, and Cultural Center.
The man don't say nothing. I know he just keep on rolling. I want you to know.